A while back, I built a water-cooled Pi 4 computer using a CM4 module and an official I/O board. This computer worked really well, but was quite bulky for a Raspberry Pi build, so I recently got to thinking how I could make it more compact. One of the challenges with this type of build is that standard water cooling parts for computers are just way too big. Even the most compact pumps, reservoirs and cooling blocks are much larger than a Pi. You can comfortably cool a whole cluster of Pis with a single water cooling kit for a full-size PC. So we need to use more unconventional hardware, and in some cases make our own parts. I tried this water cooling kit for a Pi 5 earlier in the year, and this kit has a nice water block design, but the radiator and fan are overkill. The acrylic top of this block made me wonder whether I could design a new top for the copper base that incorporates some of the tubing, and perhaps even a reservoir, which I can 3D print as an all-in-one design to make the whole build a lot more compact. This way I only need to add a fan, radiator and pump to the case, and the 3D print will take care of connecting them all together in a compact form, and will store the additional cooling liquid. So I opened up Fusion 360 and started modeling the components. The design of this case was quite a long process, probably one of the most complicated ones that I've done. In the end, I settled on a design that has the Pi mounted vertically towards the back of the case, with cutouts for the ports on the back. The Pi screws onto the water block through the side panel, and on the opposite side is the reservoir with an integrated pump. On the front we've got the radiator and fan. The cooling lines are all integrated into the print as far as possible, with short flexible runs to the pump and radiator. I then went and added some design features to the case, like a grill to cover the radiator, a top cover to install the pump through, some feet, and a Pi logo on the side of the reservoir. I'm hoping this will be a bit more visible with a contrasting colored coolant. With the design done, we now need to print it out. My first thought was to try and print the case as a large single clear resin print, so that the cooling system really is a part of the case. This turned out to be a bit of a mess. I couldn't get good results with transparent resin and such large overhanging areas. The print came out distorted and generally looked terrible. I then tried printing the whole case on an FDM printer. This surprisingly holds water better than I expected, but you can't actually see any of the coolant, and under pressure, tiny leaks form droplets along some of the seams and leak into the infill. So I abandoned the single large print idea and instead separated the tank, block and cooling lines from the case, so that I could print each part on the printer best suited for that particular part. I printed the tank and block with its cover out first. I printed this in a smoky black transparent resin, which came out looking better than the clear, mainly because the clear kept turning a weird shade of yellow when I cured it. The smoky black still provides some visibility into the tank and lines. After washing off the uncured resin, I put brass inserts into the print to mount the components onto, and then I cured it. I'm really happy with how this print turned out on its own. Next, we need the case and covers. I printed the main body of the case in a dark sparkle PLA with white accents on the fan grille and top cover, and some white feet. These will hopefully work well with the white coolants I plan to use in the reservoir. These parts also came out really well. Well, at least much better than the sad resin print looked. To finish these parts off, I just need to add some M2.5 brass threaded inserts into the main body of the case, and I'll do that with a soldering iron. Lastly, we need the side panels. Like with my other case designs, I went with laser cutting some 2mm clear acrylic so that all the internals are visible. Now let's get to assembling the case and hardware. I'll start by assembling the cooling loop. First, let's add the copper heatsink to the cooling block. My design uses the same O-ring as the original, so we can just swap that over. I really hope I've got the dimensions right on the O-ring so that this doesn't become a leak point. For the pump, I'm using a 5V submersible USB pump, which I've cut the connector off. I've crimped DuPont connectors onto the wires to plug directly into the Pi's GPIO pins for power. The pump also needs a short section of flexible tubing to connect it to the outlet through the top of the reservoir. I put a zip tie on the pump outlet because it felt a bit loose. We can then connect the radiator to the loop. This is a 60mm radiator, and I've got a 60mm 5V fan to mount onto it. Similar to the pump, I've crimped connectors onto the wires to plug it into the Pi's GPIO pins. Again, we need some short sections of flexible tubing to connect it to the 3D print. With the cooling loop mostly assembled, I'm going to give it a try before closing up the reservoir and installing it into the case. This is so that I can fix any issues with leaks or power while I still have easy access to it. With some water added to the loop and power being provided by a 5V supply, it doesn't look like we have any major problems. I left this to run for half an hour just to be sure, and I had to repair two tiny holes in the resin print. We can then close the reservoir up. I'm using some hot glue for this so that it holds it in place enough that it doesn't fall apart, but not too much so that I can't get it apart again if I need to get access to the pump. The whole assembly can then be put into the case. One screw holds the reservoir in place for now, but this will be supported by a second when the side panel is installed. Next, let's mount the Pi into the assembly. I'm plugging the pump into the Pi's 5V pins and the fan into the 3.3V pins so that it runs a bit quieter. I've left the cooling pads on the copper block in place, and the Pi is secured to the cooling loop with four M2.5 screws through the bottom. We can then finish the case off by adding the cover plates and feet, as well as installing the side panels. I realized when installing the side panel on the Pi side that I was supposed to add some ventilation holes to this panel for the air from the radiator to escape after running over the Pi. So I added these in and then cut a new side panel out. I also made up some decals for the opposite side, which are stuck into place. And that's the case complete. Let's plug in the power and HDMI cables and boot it up to test its thermals. I'm using a utility called CPU Burn to load up all four of the Pi's CPU cores. It runs much the same as my acrylic water cooling stand. At idle, temperatures start off at 28 degrees, and this goes up to about 42 degrees under full CPU load. The initial rise was a bit shallower than on my stand, but it leveled off after about a minute and a half, and it remained at 42 degrees for the remainder of the test. As expected, this setup performs way better than the standard Pi 5 active cooler, which runs almost 25 degrees hotter. After 30 minutes, when we unload the CPU, the temperature drops back down to 28 degrees in about a minute as well. So there's a lot of additional capacity for overclocking, and it's much more compact than the other water cooling setups I've built and tested. Overall, I'm really happy with how this build came out. It took far longer than I expected it to, and as always, there is some room for improvement. My next iteration is going to include a power button for the Pi, and a bit of space underneath the Pi for an NVMe drive. Let me know what you think of my water-cooled Pi 5 project in the comment section below, or if there's anything you think I should add to it. Thanks for watching. Please remember to like this video if you enjoyed it, and subscribe for more tech in electronics projects, tutorials, and reviews.